Suid-Afrikaners het vroeër hierdie week verskeie winkels ingevaar om produkte te gaan koop en hulle koskaste en dies meer aan te vul. En daar word nou gesê, moenie paniekerig raak nie, daar gaan genoeg kos wees en ons gaan so 'n bietjie meer oor hierdie onderwerp vanoggend gesels. Wandile Siglobo van Agbus sluit nou via Skype by ons aan. So good morning Wandile and thank you so much for joining us again.
Good morning, thanks for having me on.
I would like to start with your take on South Africans who panicked and went to the stores to buy a lot of food and other products.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's understandable to see what many South Africans have done when one considers the impact of what we are looking at, as well as the uncertainties that are around this. But I think, though, it's important to clarify to a number of South Africans to say, firstly, as a country, we are a net exporter of food. We literally export on an annual basis in a normal year, roughly half of what we produce in value terms. And this year is not even a normal one. We're expecting double-digit increase in a number of major grains, citruses, and some of the other fruits. So we have sufficient supplies as a country. So there is no need really for people to actually buy panic and think that South Africa could run out of food. I think as a country, we are solid in that, and we can actually be good even if we were to continue exporting to some of the countries that we typically export to. So while understandably the panic, but I think it's important to bring clarity to say we are not running out of food. If there's anything else, there are certain few basic products that we are importing. Mm. You think of rice, you think of wheat, you think of palm oil and a bit of chicken and sunflower oil. Those are the products that I would say if you're looking at the basic food products that we import. But even there, we're not really running out of the supplies. And even in areas where we typically import from, we could still get those commodities. So people shouldn't panic at this point.
And the Minister Ibrahim Patel recently said, and it's also in this morning's paper, that we don't have to be concerned about the importing of products. So you can confirm that statement, right?
Yeah, we can confirm on that statement because what South Africa has done so far is to minimize the movement of people through the ports, mm-hmm. but the movement of goods will continue as usual. So there is not a problem. But I think that the other thing, Elsa, to add is that, as I was saying, we are a net exporter of food. Some of the biggest markets where we send our agricultural and food products at is the Asia as well as Europe. Both of those countries, or those regions, they take about 50% of what we actually export to the world. Mm-hmm. And at this point, as some of the countries in those regions are going on lockdown and people are going in isolation, what that means is that the demand for the products that they would buy from South Africa is likely to be impacted. Now, if you are a farmer, that is negative for you because it's negatively affecting prices at which you are selling your products on, and that's not good for farmers. But if you are a consumer, you are benefiting somewhat there because this increase in local supplies really lowers the prices. And the other thing that I would like to add is to say some people were having fears that the retailers could lift prices because of this sudden demand that is coming up. That situation also is somewhat unlikely because our colleagues at the Competition Commission, as well as on a DTIC, Department of Trade, Industry and Competition, they're really looking at some of these things and monitoring on a day-to-day basis. And I think the message also through structures like NEDLAC and BUSA has gone out to the business leaders to say, let's understand the critical situation as a country that we are in. So I would say a number of institutions are on high alert. The consumers are not left out there for themselves. It's good for them. We have enough supplies. But if you are a farmer, this is going to be the difficult period for you because of the lower demand in the world market and the declining commodity prices.
Well, it is such a relief to know that everything is going to be okay. But when taking these fears into consideration, is there a way to manage and control this challenge more effectively at the moment?
I think what Elsa we need to do is really follow what the health authorities in South Africa has been saying, because looking at what our authorities are saying and reflecting to what is happening in Europe and in the US as well as Asia, the only way that Asia managed to flatten the curve of the coronavirus is really by following the issues like social distancing, isolation, self-isolation if you're feeling a bit sick. and doing all these kinds of things, because what they do now is to minimize the spread of the virus, therefore, so that our health system is not overwhelmed. Mm-hmm. Because I think that if we are not obeying what the health authorities are saying, which, by the way, is in line, as I say, with the other countries out there, and even better than some of the other countries in proactiveness, therefore, we're working against this, and we might end up having a bigger problem on our hands. And for countries like South Africa, you really want to make sure that you control that, because we're already having high levels of HIV, we're having high levels of TB. So there are these underlying health concerns already in our society and our communities. So if now viruses come on top of that, a number of people are already vulnerable. So I do think that I would urge people to listen to what the health authorities are saying, and we follow through those guidance. And in our side at ECBIS, we have been supportive of that government message and urging some of our members to really make sure that they follow through with what the health authorities are suggesting to us.
Now, food security is a global challenge, usually. So the overall food security at this stage?
The overall food security, Elsa, it's also even on a global level looking on relatively as solid, in a sense that you have wheat production up 5% year-on-year basis in the world. You have rice production stable, grains production, yes, less than last year, but the stocks are stable. What at the global level is going to be a problem on is the movement of the supply, because the supply chains have really been disrupted. Now, some of the countries that are not as privileged as South Africa to have a capacity to produce most of the products on themselves, they might struggle if the countries that they typically get summer supplies from are on lockdown. But as we understand, a number of the countries, they might be on lockdown on people, but for the movement of goods, there is still some activity. But obviously, that activity is not as efficient as the days before the virus. So supply chains globally are going to be a problem. Domestically, we have enough at a national level, but what the panic buying that we have seen might do is to disrupt the local supply chains, because food is produced some in a particular province and has to be moved to a certain shops, and the retailers know how much stocks they have to move at a normal time, having known the history of how the demand is looking like. But then if people go on with a lot of panic buying, they might disrupt the local supply chains, while on a global level, it's really the virus that is messing up the global supply chains. But overall, the supplies are there. It's just how to move them at the international level.
I'm going to interrupt you there for a moment, but I'm looking forward to the rest of this discussion. Ons sluit af met vanoggend se gesprek met Wandile Sihlobo van ECBIS, en dit na aanleiding van Suid-Afrikaners wat so 'n bietjie paniekerig geraak het en 'n paar winkels in gevaar het om produkte en kruideniersware te gaan koop. Intussen word alle Suid-Afrikaners gemaan om rustig te wees, kalm te bly en net te koop wat wel nodig is. Maar ons gaan dan nou voort om te hoor wat precies Wandile van hierdie storie dink. So thanks again for joining us, Wandile. What is the influence of this coronavirus on the agricultural sector?
Yeah, on the agricultural sector, so far, the impact has really been on a pricing side, at least at the international level. Because if one looks at the commodity prices, for example, over the past few weeks or so, we've started to see a bit of a decline onto that in all of the global indexes. Now, the worry now is expected to be in about two ways for South African farmers. Firstly, is through this price transmission, which we are already flagging that we're seeing internationally negative, and then it might also spill over to our side. But the second one is on that potential weakening demand. You remember that of the products that we really send to the export markets, we largely send fruits, wine, and grain. We do have a certain amount of beef that we send out, but that has already been affected by the foot and mouth disease, which has put that subsector really in a difficult conditions. Mm. Now, going forward, our worry is that from a farming side now, whether there will be enough demand out there for some of these products. But like I said, so far our ports are functioning well on that, but now that is not only depending on ourselves only, but rather the buyers in the other countries, if they continue to show the normal interest in our products. We've seen from the citrus producers that they still sent some bit of volumes to China, so there seems to be some movement in there. on a euro area, we are monitoring also on what will actually be happening there, because Europe and Asia are the biggest market for South Africa's agricultural products, followed obviously by some of the other regions that are also important, the Middle East, and to a certain extent, the Americas region. So through that demand, it's really some of the things that we think there might be disruption in the global supply chains, and we're on high alert to see what's going on that side.
There's also a lot of cancelled events as well regarding the agricultural sector.
Yeah, we are playing, I mean, ourselves as well on the Agriculture Business Chamber. In July, we were expecting to have our annual Congress, and we've sent out communication around early hours of this morning to all of our members saying that we might have to move the events into next year. But I think that it's a really good and responsible thing for most of the agricultural companies and as well as agricultural associations that have done that. And I know that there's news also around the NAMPO and all of the, and I think it's a responsible way of ensuring that all of the participants in our sector are safe and understanding, again, the seriousness of this situation. And again, the other thing is really the uncertainty, because there's a lot of unknown. Until there is some bit of a control over this, I think it's a responsible thing to hold on some of the events. And if there's anything that is really of crucial that it happens, one tries to do it online on any other platform to ensure that we minimize the physical contact as best as we can. And by doing that, we are again following through what the health authorities were suggesting. And I think that if we follow through what the health authorities are saying, we might be able to flatten that coronavirus curve, which means then our health system is not going to be overwhelmed. But the minute we are not responsible, we run into a situation where our health system can be overwhelmed. And our health system then, I doubt if it will be able to take on a large numbers if they are in critical situations. So I think managing all of these things and listening and following through to all of the communication from the Department of Health is one, as well as the other medical doctors, is one of the things that can really help us as a country to cope through with this, just as like we're seeing in Singapore and the other countries that have managed to at least minimize the impacts of this thing.
Another huge concern in our country is job losses. So when focusing specifically on the agricultural sector and this virus, what is the impact within that regard?
This is one of the things that many of us are still looking and talking to different partners on what the situation would be, because it comes at a time whereby, for example, the citrus folks have to be on harvesting side, and in a few months' time now, everybody that is on the grain side will be harvesting around about the end of May or so. And some of these things, if you are on a horticulture side, you really need hard labor in some of these products. But I think what's going to be important is obviously on the farming side and a number of agribusinesses to see what are the better ways of ensuring that while labor might still be going on in the farms, but we try to make sure that we minimize any spread of the disease as possible. So this is something that is going to be challenging for the sector, that is going to be held, need to be looked at responsible. But I think all of our partners, and certainly the ACBIS members, they pretty much are aware of those things. And I think that it's going to be a challenge on saying how do we cope with this. But at a national level now, on losses on agricultural jobs, I think in industries across, we might see, we haven't seen any physical data on this, but my sense is that we might see a reduction in employment as a number of people are reducing the headcount that can be in various fields so that we minimize the human contact. So that's certainly going to have impact on the labor market, which is why a number of people are starting now to think more about what proper or responsible economic policy to respond on. We've seen in a number of countries like the United States where they are extending some bit of our capital handouts from the government. But on the South African side, this arrives again at a time where even on our fiscal side, our government finances are constrained. So it's going to be a challenging time, Ilse.
Yes. I would like to move away from the virus for a moment. What are some of the other challenges with regard to the agricultural sector at this stage?
The big thing that we were looking at in a sector before the virus really comes out, it was more on a policy side, because at least in as far as production, this has been one of the good years that we are in. Like I said, on grains, on horticulture, this year was really a year of a recovery for many guys. So the one thing in the near term that we're worried on was the story of the land reform, which was supposed to be some discussions in parliament on the 31st of this month. But as we saw on the announcements that were put out yesterday, that there's starting to be a cancellation of those events, even in parliament. The public hearings as regards to land reform has also been postponed. So that's one of the factors that we're looking at. But obviously, the livestock sector in South Africa, while the field crops and horticulture was recovering, were still hard hit by the foot and mouth disease. So that's the second issue at which we're looking at. So I'll say those are the big major issues that we were confronting. But obviously, the new one now introduces all uncertainties across the board. But suffice to say that for a consumer, you are fine. But for an agriculture business, you might take a hit on this. These are not good times.
And then lastly, in essence, I mean, I would like to end this interview in a positive way, if possible. But are there any opportunities to be excited about at this stage? You know, just to look at the positive side of things.
Sure, I see. The opportunities to be excited about in the near term is really, I would say, for me, the better thing now is that we have better technologies than in the past. So the technologies allow at least some way the economic activity to continue. Mm-hmm. Because while we might be in the midst of the virus, economic activity has to continue to keep the country working. Mm-hmm. So that for me is one of the important things. But obviously the positive one is, again, to say from a consumer side, you can sit back, isolate and follow what the Department of Health is saying without a worry that you will be running out of food and all of those things. So we are blessed to have the farming sector producing all of this stuff that we will be needing on the sector. We're not like the other countries that if they could be hard hit, and they still have the food security concerns, then the problem could actually be exponential. So on that note, I would say that South Africa is at least sitting at a better level relative to the other countries or our neighbors and even in the euro area.
Mm-hmm. And we are going to be okay. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. This was Wandile Sihlobo from AgBiz.